It's literally so frustrating to talk about because when we talk about these players in the season, they're literally cooking people, bro. Like, cooking people. And you get to the Olympic stage where you're surrounded by talent. Like, can you imagine Damian Lillard actually on a team with help? Can you imagine Jason Tatum on a team with help? Can you imagine Zach LaVine on a team with help? They finally have help to play on the grandest stage in terms of global basketball, and you're going to tell me you cannot produce? They bitch and moan all season long about, I'm the only one doing anything, or I need help, or I just can't do this by myself, or God, man, these referees are terrible, blah, blah, blah. All these fucking excuses and complaints and everything that they fucking bitch about all season long. And now you're playing with the best of the best outside of probably the top, some of the top five players in the league, and you're literally going to tell me you still can't do it? No.
You
No,
won't
I don't
accept it.
care.
You won't accept it.
No. I know people that love basketball, people that follow the sport, there's no reason to accept it.
It's bad. It's bad. When you
Bro,
lose to
three
Portland.
losses in four games. You're the best organization in the world. Unacceptable, bro. No, just no. I've said that word 100 times every time we've talked about this damn team. Just no. There's no other word.
You don't see this as a coaching issue. You see this as a player issue.
100%, bro. This man, Greg Popovich, is like one of the best coaches in history, bro. I don't give a fuck if he's trying to make you play middle school basketball. If he tells you to play, you play.
I need to ask you just an honest question here. Do you really think these guys even want to be there?
I think they don't give a shit. I
That's
think they're just
what
there.
I'm thinking.
I think they're there to show that they could be the next star of the USA. I think they're there to just put a notch on their belt to say, I represented the country. I went out there and I tried my best, even though we know that they're not. And I think that they're just doing it to do it, just to say that they did. Because we all know when Olympic gold medal Melo did it, it was a whole different category. It was a whole different Melo. When Kobe went out there, the intensity that he brought from everybody out on that team was incredible. We saw the videos of Bron and Kobe going at it in practice. We saw the videos of fucking Chris Bosh and Kobe Bryant getting into it at the free throw line with Kobe talking shit to Louis Scola. We all know the intensity all of those greats brought to the game. I don't get that from this team. I don't see that from these guys. I see guys that say, yo, the guy in front of me is trash, but the guy next to me wants to take this shot attempt away from me. So I'm going to try and beat the guy in front of me and make a crazy shot. No, you're Damian Lillard, you're Kevin Durant, you're Jason Tatum. If the guy in front of you sucks, you should score. You shouldn't try to one-up him. You shouldn't try to be fancy. You shouldn't try to do a step back. Bro, if you know you have the dribble moves, you know they can't guard you, there's no reason why you can't get to the basket, get to the free throw line, and one, flush it on their forehead, get a good look at a mid-range jump shot, play effective and efficient basketball. You're going to tell me you're going to be so flash, you're going to come off a pick, you're going to step back, you're going to shoot a 32-foot, one-legged three-point shot, and then get upset when the ref doesn't call a tap on your fingertip instead of getting back on defense? No. If you're going to dribble into a double team and expect the refs to blow the whistle every time you bump somebody that you ran into, that's not smart basketball. That's called being spoiled because the NBA hand delivers fouls.
Yep. And that was really the point that I was going to hit. This is really a reflection on the NBA and how soft it has gotten. Granted, I know the NBA has made a big pivot from really the gritty, aggressive, physical game that it used to be back in the 90s to more of a offensively centric game that we all see on the court day in and day out. But what you get is guys that are soft. They are looking for contact, and when they even get the smidgen, they get a smidgen of contact, they're literally looking at the ref saying, why'd you blow the whistle? FIBA is
They just
different.
stop playing.
This is not the NBA. This is FIBA. This is, honestly, the way that I think FIBA has it set up with how the refs ref the game, this is what I want to see in the NBA. This is what it should be. But the NBA has gotten really lax and really soft when it comes to these fouls that they call all the time. And when I look at these guys, when it's the superstars, Kevin Durant, Jason Tatum, Damian Lillard, and just the role players that go along with it looks like they're just going through the motions. They're going up against a team that they know that they can beat, but they're playing down to their competition. That is not how it's supposed to be. I don't care who you're going up against, whether it's Nigeria, whether it's against Ghana or Jamaica or whatever country that you could think of. I'm just thinking of a couple of like subpar basketball teams at the top of my head. You play against them like you're playing against the best team in the world. It doesn't matter who they are. And against France, look, they were up 8 points at one point with, like, I want to say, like, half of the fourth quarter left to go. Yeah. And then they just completely just, they take their foot off the gas pedal and give up 16 points in 3.5 minutes. I'm like, this team is better than that. We know that this team can play better. But if they don't get their heads out of their asses, it's going to be a very short Olympic run for me. And that's why I kind of mentioned, it's like, do they even want to be there? That's a real question that I have to ask.
And that's why I don't think they're going to.
I think the reason why is that they know they just went through the last like 7 to 8 months playing the game, coming off of a 2.5 month layoff from the bubble the year prior. And I think they're just like, you know what? It's not worth it.
So don't play. Don't play.
I'm like, I'll go find some guys that actually want to play.
Thank you. Give somebody else a shot. There are plenty of players in the league that were invited to the camp. They were considered to be. And then there were players that just denied it. LeBron said, I'm not doing it. Steph said he's not doing it. And the litany of other players that they wanted to have on this initial roster said, yo, I'm not doing it. Whether or not that was because of fatigue, whether or not that was because of family, or because they were just straight up just like, I don't feel like it. If you don't feel like giving this 100%, you should not be on the court. You should not be representing this country. There's no reason why you aren't giving it 100% if you're on the roster. If you reported to camp, if you said yes to being here, you need to fucking be here. Mm-hmm. Not only on the offensive end, not only when you want to put up 15 shots and make four of them, but on the defensive end because this is a two-way sport. Whether or not these teams are on the same level as you, but if you're going to lose and look like a bunch of idiots, there's no reason why the next game after you lose, you should not be on your top of your A game saying, I'm never letting this happen again. He is not going to beat me. The guy in front of me is not better than me. I'm not going to let him outscore me. And that's the mentality that this team should have.
And the thing is, I would rather have a bunch of amateur basketball players than going out there. I'd rather have a bunch of amateur players going out there, giving it everything that they've got, compared to having superstars out in the court who are giving maybe half effort, 75% effort. They're not giving 100% effort.
What's that mode in 2K, my team, where you're like, you're playing with like scrubs at the beginning and then like you have to open packs and like acquire, like you have to play with like a shit team and then like as you acquire more packs, you get like better players. This is what it feels like. I feel like we legitimately have a my team, but, like, we have gold packs for, like, everybody, but they're just literally saying, like, fuck it, I'm just going to throw shots up from half court because I just, you know, we're that good, we're going to beat them no matter what.
I'm like, you could do that all you want in the NBA. That might work out. But when it comes against international teams, I'm telling you what, I don't care if it's, I know we mentioned this earlier, whether it's Slovenia, whether it's Greece, whether it's France, these guys have national pride, and they're playing with pride. They're stepping up for their own countries. In the United States, these guys are not showing it. And it's like I mentioned, I'd rather have some amateur basketball players giving it everything that they've got on this team than some glorified superstars who can drop 50 points whenever they damn well please, but
will,
are going out there,
will.
But are giving, going out there and throwing up bricks at playing at maybe 75%. This team should not be scoring 76 points in an international game.
Against 70, Rudy Gobert.
76? There are some teams that could score 80 points in a half, for God's sakes. 80. You're talking about 76 and four quarters? No way.
Do you know what's crazy? Luka Doncic by himself scored more points than the USA did in the second half.
It's unacceptable. It's disgraceful. It really
bro,
is.
Bro, one player on a team with nobody. Nobody of actual recognition. One fucking player. A 22-year-old kid. One player. I'm going to say it again. One fucking player scored more than the whole United States men's basketball team in a half. Are you so you're telling me Luka Doncic is better than the starting five? If you were to mash up all the best parts of the starting five, Luka Doncic is just better than all of them, right? He's a better defender than Draymond. He's a better rebounder than Bam. He's a better scorer than KD. He's a better ball handler than Damian Lillard. Like, that's basically what you're telling me. Because he went out there and he said, I represent this country. This is my homeland. I want to win. And he showed that in every facet of the way. I don't give a shit if you played an older Argentina team. You're playing against France with a total of four NBA players, and one of them didn't even suit up. There's zero reason why the bench couldn't come up and annihilate the starting five. If you put Devin Booker in a room with Evan Fournier, Devin Booker's winning that game all day long. If you're putting a game between Rudy Gobert and Bam Adebayo, that might be a little bit closer because Rudy is a great defender, but overall, offensively, Bam is more talented because Bam can shoot. And the list continues. Nicholas Batum's like 33 years old. You're telling me somebody on this team...
Drew Holiday. Drew Holiday had a good game, though.
He's been on the team for like 5 days, and he led the team in scoring. 5 days? Coming off of a full season, a full postseason, an NBA championship, a parade, God knows how many parties he went to celebrate his championship. And he came all the way out to Tokyo to outscore a team that's been together for 3 weeks. No. 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 I've had enough. Kyle, I'm going to fucking give myself an aneurysm.